CBS News has confirmed that Deputy Attorney General Rod Rosenstein has been interviewed by the Special Counsel's Office about the firing of former FBI Director James Comey. It happened over the summer as part of the Mueller team's probe of Russia meddling in the 2016 presidential election. Paula Reid is our CBS News Justice reporter. She joins me now from Washington with the latest. Paula, tell us what you've learned about this interview.
Rena, this puts investigators in a really interesting position because here they are questioning the man who has authority over this entire investigation. We have confirmed that some of Mueller's investigators have interviewed Deputy Attorney General Rod Rosenstein about the circumstances under which former FBI Director Comey was fired. Now, as you may remember, Rosenstein was the author of a memo outlining his concerns about how Comey handled the investigation into Hillary Clinton's emails, specifically all of the public announcements that he made leading up to the election, sort of supporting his firing. But as we now know, the White House may or may not have used that as their sole reason for firing FBI Director Comey.
So what do you think this means for the course of the Russia investigation, Paula?
Rena, this is incredibly significant because this is further evidence that Mueller's probe has expanded to look at the circumstances under which Comey was fired and whether or not there could have potentially been any obstruction of justice. And this isn't the only clue that we have about this. Just last week, the Justice Department declined to let two of the investigators on this case testify before Congress, specifically saying in writing in a letter to Congress that they could not allow them to testify because they could not deconflict Comey's firing. That's just a fancy lawyer way of saying, look, we can't allow them to testify about this because this is likely part of the work that they're doing for Mueller. And Rena, of course, that's significant because that means that Attorney General Sessions, who also wrote a letter in support of Comey's firing, Deputy Attorney General Rod Rosenstein, and of course, the President of the United States himself, all of them and the decisions that they made around this firing are now coming under scrutiny by the special counsel.
So, Paul, if it's coming under scrutiny, what do you think this means for Rod Rosenstein's role overseeing the entire investigation?
Well, that's the big question here, right? Can you be both a witness and a supervisor in a highly politicized investigation like this? Most legal experts I talk to say it's not legally or politically feasible for him to remain in this oversight role. And let's remember, the reason Deputy Attorney General Rod Rosenstein is overseeing the special counsel's office is because the Attorney General, Jeff Sessions, he had to step aside because he failed to disclose previous contacts he had had with the Russian ambassador. So if Rod Rosenstein has to step aside, oversight of Mueller would fall to the number three at the Justice Department, Rachel Brand.
So is there a scenario, Paula, where Rosenstein would be asked to step down from that role?
Certainly. I do think we're going to probably start hearing increasing calls for that. But as of this afternoon, the Justice Department has released a statement saying that his role has not changed. And the statement says, quote, as the Deputy Attorney General has said numerous times, if there comes a time when he needs to recuse, he will. However, nothing has changed. But Rena, something has changed. He has become a witness in this investigation. So I think absolutely you are going to see people calling for him to perhaps step aside.
Yeah. I want to ask you before you go, what do you make of the timing of this interview?
CBS News has not been able to confirm when this interview occurred. Now, the Wall Street Journal that broke this story, they reported that the interview happened sometime over the summer in June or July. And Rena, if Rosenstein still decides, if he still says, look, I can be a witness and the supervisor, you know, I don't think the timing really amounts to much. But if he was to step aside in the next few days, that is troublesome because he would only really be stepping aside because his interview became public. And that is, of course, exactly what happened with Attorney General Jeff Sessions. He didn't recuse himself until meetings that he had, reasons that many people could say could have maybe given him reason to step aside earlier, became public. It wasn't until it was published by the Washington Post that he recused. And if you see the same pattern with Rosenstein, that really isn't great for sort of the integrity of the Justice Department's leadership and the supervisory role they have over Mueller's independent investigation.
You're right, Paula. Certainly a lot to consider there. I want to thank you, CBS News Justice reporter Paula Reid in Washington.